Boom! You heard him.
But he was alive.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
Good morning, everyone. We're just getting ready for our lineup. Whereas everyone, please have a match. If you don't have one, we have one for you. See Mr. Patterson right here. A Charles. So listen to the lineup, please, ma'am and please, sir. We want the husband, the daughter, the son and his spouse, the grandchildren, the sisters, grandchildren. K. Can we get a loud twos? Brothers right behind the sisters. And a line of two for me, please. And the nieces and nephews and friends behind the family, a line of two for me, please. Is a river. The streams whereof shall make glad the city of God. The holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her. And that right early, the heathen rage, the kingdoms were moved, and he uttered his voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord is merciful and he is gracious. He is slow to anger and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He has not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far he has removed our transgressions from us. Like as a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame. He remembereth that we are as dust. As for man, his days are as grass. As a flower of the field, so he flourishes. For the wind passeth over it, and is gone. And the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto the children's children. To such keep his covenant, and to those that remember his commandments to do them. Amen. To God be the glory today. We praise him for who he is, and we do claim him and know that he is our God. As we come to celebrate this life and memories of our dear sister, Christine Abrams Chandler, and we do this on this day, February the 5th, 2022, at 10 a.m. Her sunrise was November the 15th, 1953. Sunset, January 30th, 2022. And we celebrate this life today at the New Springfield Baptist Church Cemetery, Waynesboro, Georgia, at where our eulogist today is Reverend Pastor Bobby Williams Sr. and pastor of the church here is Reverend Barrett Madison. Amen. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we've gathered here to celebrate this life. The family has gone through extended time and carefulness to plan out the program, the service, the order of worship, and we will abide by that as they have asked us to do unless otherwise directed. We know it's chilly, so we're going to ask that everyone be mindful of the weather and the family. Amen. That we don't spend too much time out here in the cold, but at the same time give reverence to our dear sister Chandler. We're going to ask Reverend Barrett Madison, pastor of New Springfield, to read our scriptures, Old and New Testament. We'll be back with the prayer. Following that, we'll have friends and family. We're going to limit those remarks by a neighbor, Cynthia Kelly, family, Alberta Lovett, and a friend, Lisa Jordan. We'll come back after that.
Amen, amen. Did I say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen again. First, giving honor and glory to God, to all the my fellow co-laborers in the Lord in their respective places, to other men and women of God who may be sitting in the audience. I bring you greetings from the New Springfield Baptist Church. Amen. To the bereaved family, Brother Gene, Sister Monique, the rest of the bereaved family, I pray the comfort and ministry of the Holy Spirit that camp around about you now and give you that promised peace that surpasses all understanding. He promised us another comforter. And so we take comfort in knowing that even in times like this, he says we can have comfort in him. Amen. Our scripture reading, Old Testament, is Psalm 73, verses 24 through 26. And we read from the New King James Version. And it reads, "You will guide me with your counsel, and afterward receive me to glory. Whom I have in heaven but you, and there is none upon earth that I desire besides you. My flesh and my heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever." New Testament readings come from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 4. I'm going to read verses 6 through 8, and it reads, "For I am already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearance. Amen. It's an honor and a privilege to be before you this morning. Stay strong. Amen. Let us pray together. Our Father, which art in heaven, we approach the throne of grace now. And God, we come to you this morning humbly asking and beseeching your mercy upon this family, this husband and this daughter and son, friends and siblings and friends and loved ones. And God, we come praying for not their strength, but we come praying for your strength. That your strength will be with them. God, we thank you for being the God of all comfort. Comfort that we cannot give them. Comfort that they can't even give to each other. But we know, God, that you can comfort them in these sacred times, in these times of pain and hurt. God, we approach you in thanking you for all these lives that Sister Chandler has touched, as evidenced by the attendance and even the desires of those who wanted to be here. God, we thank you for her life, the lives that she's touched. But most of all, God, we thank you for the life that you gave to her through your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for his life. But because of his life and because of his death and because of his resurrection, we know that there is another life. God, you told us in your word that it's to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So we take comfort, God, even right now, in knowing that Sister Chandler is with you and your Son Jesus. Bless God, this family, bless those loved ones that are caring and hurting, those colleagues, the school system, and all that are hurting because of the tragedy of her death. But God, we beseech you, and God, we commend them to you as the God of all comfort. Bless them now is our prayer. And then God, we pray for Reverend Bobby Williams Sr., even right now, as he prepares to deliver your word of encouragement to this family. Bless him as he stands today is our prayer. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. I'm speaking on behalf of a neighbor. When I moved into the neighborhood, I was in my early 20s. Now I'm in my late 50s, almost 60. And from the time I moved there, it was always nothing but love. We call her Tim, but she was a great neighbor, soft-spoken person. Always have a smile. So I say to the family, just pray. God will take care of everything else. First, give unto God, who's the head of my life. Amen. To the clergies, family, friends, and well-wishers. It's an honor for me to stand up here today and speak, because Tina and I go way back from the beginning. We worked together,
And every Monday, she been looking for me to come to the new Wayne because she knew I had some cake for her. She loved my pound cake. She'll say, Mr. Dorr, you need it on the new Wayne. So they knew what that meant. They had cake. And so we just had good time together. We talked, we ate lunch together, we prayed together, y'all. Because that's all we need prayer.
Amen.
And we did that.
Amen.
So, and after we prayed together, we talked. You know, she wasn't a talkative person. She was a private person. And what we tell each other, that's all the for it with. If we didn't know it, you didn't know it because she wasn't going to tell it. And we all know that. And me and her both had foot problems together. We both couldn't walk, we were hopping along. We could share our remittances, what our doctor told us to do, and we did that. So one day I went over there, I said, Tina, I said, what kind of shoes you got on? She said, I got on one that makes me comfortable. So you the one always around here trying to go matching up and uncoupling and hopping. She said, I said, well, where you got these shoes from? She told me, and I said, okay, I'm going right now. I don't want to be pretty no more. I want to be comfortable. And Nick, Tom, Jean, Mama, Mitt, Bill, Sonny, and the rest of the family. Tina love y'all. She love y'all. She might have not been everywhere that we was going or supposed to be, but her support was there. Because you know she didn't get, you know, go a whole lot of places that we went and showed up. But she was there in spirit, you know? She supported whatever we needed. And Sam, I'm saying to you today, that's all we need. We need love. Tell Amen. Each one every day that you love them.
Amen.
That you love them because that's what it was. God is love.
Amen.
Because you are not going to get there because you got to love me.
Okay.
And I got to love you. Amen. Thank you.
To the family, Ms. Chandler, this is an easy task, and yet it is a hard task. It's easy because of her friendship with me, and it's hard because of the timing. I can still see Ms. Chandler standing in the hall on last Friday at 4 o'clock when I was about to leave, and she told me and Jordan, bye, and I said, okay, and I said, I'll see you on Monday, and I said, have a great weekend. As normal, it could be taught. So, on Monday, when Monday came, it's just the fact that I got to school, but I didn't come Monday because I was just still in shock. So it's just amazing that now, when I come to school, I don't see her. And I just miss her already. So she is a big loss, but still it's having gain. Ms. Chandler was a very nice person. Quiet, reserved. Somebody just said, if you tell her something, you don't have to worry about it going anywhere else. That she's going to keep it. I'm not going to be up here telling any stories and any of our little secrets, because some of you all do want the tea. She took it to the grave, and so would I. She was a very private person. Once you get to know her, I wish the ones that didn't know her deeply that you would have gotten to know her. She was full of wisdom. She was kind. She always going to give you some good advice. I went through a whole lot, and she was there with me through my throat. She and I, one of the big conversations was shoes. I'm a shoe fanatic, and so was she. So we talked about shoes, and when the pandemic hit, I went online. I told her she come to my classroom. She come there with. I just pull up the website. So look at these shoes. So once we did that, it's just a great. She just had a great, sweet spirit about herself, and I hope that the family could continue that. to Monique and Jean, really, her in-laws, who she talked about a lot. She loved, truly loved you all. Carry that love on. May God be with you all, and may God bring you peace.
As we proceed with the outline of the services, let me just ditto with Sister Lisa, is that and I share it with Monique and all that. As you read in that in the obituary, she was a devoted member of the Noah's Ark Missionary Baptist Church, and she didn't make a lot of noise. She didn't have to be in every meeting, but one of the signs of I would put it like this, of a good member is that one of the things she did during this pandemic, I was telling Monique, every week or two, I would see a money order coming in the mail supporting the ministry of the church. And that's unusual. When you don't come and you still support, that's a sign of your love for your ministry, for the ministry. And we thank God for her doing that. And the other thing was, as her pastor, she would always make sure, Jean, you probably didn't know it, but she made sure you were prayed for. I mean, she made sure that whenever something was going on, she would say, Pastor Howard, pray for my husband. And she did that religiously, and as a wife ought to do. Amen. And she cared for you so much. And we love your family, and we love all of you, and we thank God for her being a member of our church, and we will miss her as well. You probably already have read the obituary, so we're going to ask Miss Annie Godby, and she will come and acknowledge the acknowledgement of condolences. Then Evangelist Minister Brenda Lane will come and do a selection, and following that, we'll have our eulogy by Reverend Bobby Williams, Sr. Amen.
We pray for appreciation and sincere thanks for the family who is today. We wish to acknowledge every person's thoughtful expressions of sympathy, encouragement, and love children in the time of suffering. Our hearts are glad because of the very prayers like you. May God continue to bless.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. We praise God for being here today. Amen. And to the family, we just say lift your heads and just give God praise even in the midst of death. Amen. Amen. Now, this, you know, Tina was a person, she wasn't a loud person, as Pastor stated, but she loved good church. Amen. And so, you know, we're going to sing this song. This is a song that she requested some time ago. That in her passing or whatever, if I was the longest liver, that she wanted this song. Amen. Amen. And so I'm going to do the best that I can. And to the family, God, I love you, and God does as well. I was trying to wait on Brother Ryan. He's somewhere. But we're not going to get started. He is here. He just got here. Amen. But we're going to not prolong the time. Lord, I want to live for Thee. Every with me, with me in his saving power. Oh, thank you, Lord, in my weakness be my strength in my trials, oh, my every call. Call. Oh, thank you, Lord. Lord, I really want to live for thee. Yeah, every day, and I, oh, let the Spirit, let it be with me in his saving power.
Give an honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the head of our life. Thank God for the Holy Ghost, which is our babysitter. Jesus, who is my elder brother, to the presiding of this program, Pastor Howard, to Reverend Madison, pastor of this church, and to the bereaved family, members, friends, visitors. Once again, it's just good to often say be among each individual here celebrating the homegoing, amen, of my friend, sister, Christine Chow. Notice on a sad occasion, but yet is a joyful occasion of someone home going. And it's good to go home. We all got to go home one day, ready or not. Amen. We got to leave here. Amen. Amen. And I learned in life, you don't have to be sick to leave. Because the Bible said, every life is numbered. Amen. And it's up to us to prepare ourselves to go back with Jesus when he comes. I'm a short talker, I'm a fast walker. Amen. I know it's cold out here. And that is the reason I didn't take my head off, because I don't have no hair on my head. Amen. Amen. Call your attention. The book of Proverbs, the 3rd chapter, 5 and 6. Not that I'm preaching to my friend that gone on, but I'm preaching to you all. let you know you got to prepare yourself. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. And I just want you for a thought, just a few moments. Amen. Amen. There is life after death. Amen. Some don't believe that though, but there is life after death. Amen. And I heard, amen, the good word that was spoken of her, amen, about you could tell us something and she won't tell nobody. But I tell you, don't tell me, cause I sure tell. All right. Amen. All right. Amen. I tell it. Amen. Amen. Brother Gene Challenge, he'll tell you. I'll tell it. Amen. 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 There is life after death. I'm going to try to hold about 10 minutes. Amen. Amen. If any other, you charge it to my head, not my heart. Amen. Amen. There'll come a time in life, amen, that trouble will come. I heard Job said, 14:14, amen, man that born of a woman is of a few days full of trouble, coming forth like a flower and is cut down. I learned in life that we, amen, know some things, but we don't know all things. Am I right about it? Amen. We take, amen, death sometimes as a sadness. But I learned in life that death is the best friend that we have. Because, amen, there is no pain in death. Am I right about it? Amen. We rely on knowing that we got to leave here. Amen. Ready or not. Because Jesus is coming back again. Am I right about it? So then we need to set our house in order. Amen, amen. Because you know how we used to play hide and seek? Tippy, tippy, noby, noby, noby. Are you ready? Here I come. Am I right about it? Man, this way, Jesus is saying, amen, be ye ready? Amen, because I'm coming back again. Am I right about it? Hold me, Holy Ghost. Amen. I learned in life, amen, in Ecclesiastes 3:1, it said, amen, that everything there is a time and a season. Amen. A time to be born and a time to die. Am I right about it? Yes, well, but I heard Paul saying on one occasion, that I'd rather be absent from the body and prison with the Lord. Am I right about it? I remember Mary and Martha who had a brother called Lazarus. And one day Jesus had left the territory to tell me Lazarus took sick. And they sent word to Jesus telling them who that love is, amen, is sick. Am I right about it? In order to make it short, when Jesus got the message, for the Bible said, amen, he tarried for 2 long days. Am I right about it? And Martha and Mary were looking for Jesus. Oh, yeah, nah. They kept looking for Jesus to come. Am I right about it? But when Jesus made up his mind to go unto Martha and Mary, one day mother was standing out there. She saw Jesus coming. Am I right about it? She ran and she threw her arms around Jesus. Yes, she said, Jesus, if you had been here. And I know some people have said that. Jesus, if you had been here, my brother had not died. Am I right? I heard Jesus said, your brother shall live again. Am I right about it? I heard Martha got smart. Jesus, I know he should live again in the last days of the resurrection. Am I right? I heard Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Ain't God all right? Jesus said, show me the grave where he lies. Ain't God all right? The Bible said Jesus went to the grave. He called Lazarus' name. The Bible said God's spirit went down in the grave, began to shake on Lazarus. Ain't God all right? And Lazarus got up. Ain't God all right? I heard him saying, loosen him and let him go. Ain't God all right? I heard Jesus said, he that believes in me, though he was dead, yet shall he live. Ain't God all right? I stop by to tell the Marine family that Christine, Gina, Gina, and the daughter, Gina, that he or she is not dead. Ain't God all right? For the Bible said, hold me, Holy Ghost, just for a little while. I'm trying to tame myself. The body, Ecclesiastes 12:7 said, the body that go back to the dust, but our soul go back to God. They who give it. Don't worry. Nothing wrong with crying. The Bible said, the shortest verse of the Bible, Jesus wept. Jesus wept. But there is life after death. The body remained behind, but her soul, her spirit, is with God. With God. Read it, Ecclesiastes 12:7. Amen. There is life after death. But we must keep, amen, her life going by remembrance of the good time. The good time. That's what keep you going. And I tell Gene, that would keep you going. You remember her. She was a good wife to Gene. Hallelujah. She was a good wife to Gene. When Gene was in the hospital. Amen. She was there every day, every night. Amen. I was just about there every day. Amen. So he had a good wife. I know he gonna miss her. But I tell him to keep her dreaming. Amen. In remembrance. How good she was to him. Amen. The Bible said a man that finds a wife, he finds a good thing. Amen. Amen. And I say to the family, just hold on. Keep trusting in God. Amen. Lean not to your own understanding. God is able to make a way out of nowhere. Amen. At this time.
Brothers and sisters, this is our committal service. We're going to commit the body to the grave here, and the funeral directors will direct us following that, the family following that. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our sister, We therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection at the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, at whose coming to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead. The bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and be made like his glorious body, according to that power by which he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Amen. We're going to ask Reverend Madison if he will come and do our dismissal prayer and benediction.
Every head bowed, every eye closed. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we just thank you and praise you, Father God, for this time of coming together to celebrate the life of Sister Christine Chandler. Now, Father God, we know that in the coming days, Father God, we know, Father God, that you gave us this comforter, Father God. And we know that in the coming days, Father God, that you will give this family a settled peace that surpasses all understanding. Father God, we know that you are sovereign and all things are in your hand and all things are under your control. So, Father God, we just thank you now for leading us and guiding us through this time in Jesus' name. Now, Father God, we thank you that even though we leave this place, we know we never leave your presence. Traveling grace is ours as we go back to our place of destination. In Jesus' name, amen.